Now, this is again the next question asked in GATE 2019 for DC machine. This is the very simple question. You can see the DC shunt motor takes 3 ampere at no load condition. It means there is no load in the shaft, but still it is 3 ampere is drawing by the motor. Now, the terminal voltage of the DC shunt motor is 220 volt. The shunt field resistance is 220 ohm. Armature resistance is 0.5 ohm. So all the data are given. Nothing is mentioned. Nothing is skipped. It takes 25 ampere at full load. So two cases are given, no load and full load with 1500 RPM. It means the 1500 RPM is the speed at the full load. Now the question is about the no load speed of the motor is dash RPM. So we have two cases, that is no load. So if I take no load, so the diagram of the shunt motor will look like this. Now, at no load condition, the line current or the drawn by the motor is 3 ampere for terminal voltage 220 volt. Now, the shunt resistance is given, so I can take ISH is equal to VT upon RSH. So how much? 220 by 220. So this is 1 ampere. Now 3 ampere is taken by the motor, 1 ampere is going in the shunt winding. So it's quite obvious the value of armature current at no load will be equal to 2 ampere, because for motor IL equal to IA plus ISH by applying the KCL. So the armature current drawn by the motor is IL minus ISH. So it will equal to 3 minus 1, 2 ampere. First point. Second, the value of no load induced EMF will be equal to VT minus IA into RA. So the value of VT is 220 volt, IA ki value 2, RA ki value 0.5, so we are getting 219 volt. So the back EMF for the no load case is 219. It's quite obvious, jab bhi humko speed ki zarurat hoti hai, to hum log hamesha nikalte hai back EMF. So back EMF is given, nikal liya hum logo ne. Ab aata hai full load. So full load mein kya hoga? Full load mein the current drawn by the motor is given around 25 ampere. So shunt mein to current change hoga nahi. Shunt current will be equal to still 1 ampere because we are not going to change the resistance or the voltage. Dono change nahi ho raha hai. So shunt resistance, sorry, shunt current is not going to change. Now the only quantity is, now the load is added in the shunt motor. If the load aa gaya, to quite obvious motor ko jyada current draw karna padega. So it quite obvious IL ki value 25 ampere given hai full load mein. Now we can find the armature current at full load. So if we apply the KCL here, the value of IA will be equal to IL minus ISH. So it will be equal to 25 minus 1, that is 24 ampere. So if I say this is 1, all this is 1, this is 2, it's okay, no problem. So if I find the value of back EMF at full load, what will happen? This is equal to VT minus IA of full load into RA. So this will be equal to 220 minus 24 into 0.5. So we are getting 220 minus 12, that is 208 volt. Now, to find the speed, we can use the value of, we can use the formula of E1 by E2 is equal to KT phi 1 N1 upon KT phi 2 N2. Now the same motor we are using, so motor constant will same. We are not going to change the voltage or field resistance, so flux will be also constant. So we can use E1 by E2 is equal to N1 by N2. So if I say this is no load, so no load upon full load equal to no load speed at, no load upon speed at full load. So no load speed will be equal to ENL, kitna ENL? 219. Full load speed is 1500 RPM. Full load voltage is 208. So after solving, we are getting around 1579-3269 RPM. This is the speed of the motor under no load condition. So this is a simple question based on the DC machine.